The Hive Chronicles.
The Hive Chronicles.
The Hive Chronicles.
The Hive Chronicles.
So, it is time.
It is.
It's time.
It is finally here. The Hive Chronicles is back!
Yes!
Oh my God! Finally! Finally, we have made it back to these seats.
We're back.
Absolutely.
Actually, they're new seats.
Right.
Girl, we pay for the price.
Period.
And we're here.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
In the Bria, building.
We're here.
I know.
Oh my gosh.
Hive Chronicles 2022.
Let's 2022. It's been a long time coming, but before we get into that, let us introduce ourselves. I am Duran Jordan.
I am Bria Epps.
And I am La.
And we are the Hive Chronicles. And we are here to serve you, Slaygluu. I am so excited to be here. We are filming here in Atlanta, and it feels so good to be alive.
No, okay, period. No pun intended.
It really does feel so good to be alive, to see you guys, you girls, pretty faces. I'm so thankful for you guys, but I do want to introduce everyone to you before we talk about what we're getting into today and where has the show been this long? It's been,
you've been MIA.
Girl, it's been a minute. I think our last show was a live show. And the last show was 2019.
Yikes.
It's now 2022. Oof. Yeah.
It's been a minute.
But we'll get to that in a minute. But to my left, I want to introduce you all to the beautiful and talented choreographer, content creator. You know her as Creatively La on Instagram and on TikTok. She's a TikToker.
Right.
She's a TikToker. But I want to introduce you to La. Hey, La.
Hey, boo.
What's up, girl? Well,
thank you for the introduction.
You're welcome.
I'm happy to be here.
Okay. What's going on? Tell the people who you are and what you do, girl.
So I'm La. I am a dancer, been dancing for about 18 years, teaching and doing choreography for about 10.
Oh no.
Wow.
Side note, my dream is to be one of Beyonce's dancers at some point, and it's going to happen.
It is.
Period.
It
put it into existence.
Right, it is.
And I do content creation for some of your favorite brands, and that's about it for me.
That's amazing. Well, that's a lot.
Right, I thought that's enough, honey.
Okay. Oh my gosh. I didn't even know. You've been doing this for 10 years?
Mm-hmm. Sheesh.
Girl. And what you say you did for 18 years?
I've been dancing for 18 years.
You've been dancing for 18 years?
I've been teaching for 10.
Mm-hmm. Damn. And she can dance too, y'all.
She can.
Go check it out.
She can. What's your favorite Beyonce song to dance to?
End of Time.
Oh.
That's
how you know she can dance. Yes. That's how you know.
Girl, as soon as the...
Yeah.
Like, it just hits you.
It's before that. You got to hit him with the Mrs. Carter Show World Tour.
Oh, my God.
Oh, come on.
Doom.
Yeah, she know what she's talking
about. Okay. No, don't make me start.
Yeah.
Don't make me start.
Yes.
Okay, so sitting to my right is the most angelic girl that I know.
Aww.
She's a woman. I'm sorry. She's not a girl. But she's such a sweetheart, and she's so loving. Mm-hmm. She is a screenwriter, and she's just one of the most, like I said, she's just so giving. You ever meet somebody that you know is just like an angel sent exact straight from God?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's her. That's definitely her. But Miss Bria Epps is in the room, child.
Yeah.
She's on
the show now.
So, Bria, please tell the people who you are and what you about, girl.
Well, first of all, I'm so happy to be here. I'm excited for this season. I can't wait. But, yeah, I'm Bria Epps. I'm a screenwriter upcoming here in Atlanta. I've been screenwriting for, like, 4 years now. So, yeah, check me out on IG. I got some shorts. And
she said four.
4 years. Yeah,
we love
no
that
pun
number.
Intended again.
That part.
But we yeah, I've done some shorts. I got some stuff on IG, so check it out. I'm excited.
Right. So I think it's only right that the people know how we introduce us. Oh, I forgot.
Hello.
My bad.
Just flowing.
I'm right. Sorry.
Because let's take
just
a second.
Skipped right
okay,
by.
Go ahead.
Let's take a second and really just get into the person at the head of the table.
Hello.
To my right, the absolute king of the Beehive. There is no other. No other.
None.
An influencer. Mm. Okay. Someone who really just, if you heard it, you heard it here first, boo.
That's right.
Okay.
Don't forget Ivy Park Ambassador.
Thank you.
I was getting there, but you know.
I was just saying.
I mean, an Ivy Park Ambassador. Mm. Mm-hmm. Again, if you heard it, you heard it here first.
Facts.
Mr. Deron Jordan.
Oh my god, thank you. You know, sometimes when people introduce you, you be like, wow, I did all that.
I did.
That's all me.
That's you.
That's you.
Wow, that's all God. Hey, I'm going to call it right there.
Come on.
It was God. It's all God. But no, I am so just elated to be finally coming back and doing this in this form. Mm-hmm. We've never done an actual podcast, so it was only right. I felt like we should have the video and do you know, audio as well, because I just think we're all that in a bag of chips.
Period.
And it's
Flaming Hot Cheetos. Okay. But no, I'm really excited. It's been a really, really long time coming, but again, I want to let people know how we kind of met. So if you did not know, not only am I a Ivy Park ambassador, but these two ladies was featured on We Are Ivy Park's page as well.
We were.
We did a video back in December for... well, I guess we can say it was Ivy Park. It wasn't official, but a lot of people thought it was. So we went along with it. Okay. We got the auto, we got the sign off from We Are Ivy Park when they posted us. They posted our video. And then they also posted our pictures and stuff. So it was, that was the first time I ever met La, and she was just so sweet. And me and Bria has been friends for years. So it's just been a really loving environment between all three of us. And I just felt like when I wanted to come back and do the show, I said, who can I bring to the table that I know will have a real perspective on what it is about what's going on with our girl, what's going on with rumors and things of that nature. And I couldn't think of two more important, beautiful women other than you two. So
thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm happy to be here.
You're welcome. I do love y'all. Love you. But let's get into some teams, okay? So first off, I want to say that the past host, because let's go ahead and get the stuff out the way. We look like Destiny Child. It's like it's the members just keep leaving, we keep adding on. It's a lot, okay? When we first started, when I first started the Hive Chronicles, it was back on April 4th, 2018. It was right in the height of Everything Is Love. Also, what tour was that?
On the Run 2.
Actually, I'm lying. It was actually May of last year. I mean, May of 2018. But I remember so vividly having a dream about the Hive Chronicles before I even stepped foot on any stage or anything. And I'm just so amazingly thankful to God that I have come this far and the show has come this far. When we first started, we started at it was one of the co-hosts. We started in their living room, no, in their dining room, and it was a poster that kept falling. If you go back, you'll see some of the old video. You'd be like, "Ooh, child, the ghetto." Okay. But now look at we done made it.
We here.
I can't believe we made it.
Okay.
This is what we're thankful for.
Period.
Okay. But no, seriously, like, this is amazing that we're finally here. We were supposed to come back 2020, but we all knew what happened in 2020. And so now that the world is starting to get back to itself, I felt there's no better way to do this. And Beyoncé is definitely coming soon, but not soon enough. She's definitely coming.
Absolutely.
Definitely. But we'll be here when she does come.
We'll be ready and waiting.
And there's no beef, just so that I can say, there's no beef with the old co-host. So to Toyin, to Dion, to Dee Dee, to Michelle, and to Coco Elaine, I love y'all. I am so thankful for the journey that you all have had with us. But now it's time to grow, and it's time to introduce new things mm-hmm. and new people. How about that?
Mm-hmm. Love to see you.
So, and I want to say this. So Bria is not only just a content creator. Her dad is he's one of those super famous people. He's like, her dad is like, when I first met Bria, did we meet at the Formation Tour?
We did.
We met at the Formation Tour, and I just fell in love with her, right? I was like, oh my God, I love this girl. She's so amazing. She's so beautiful. And she's so humble. Like, she's just so sweet. And she was like, come with me. We going to the party. Come with me. Like, it was done.
And
it
that sounds like Bria.
I was like, let's go.
Instant. Her and Skylar, because I think that's when I really met Skylar too.
Same time.
Not your child, but our friend.
Right. Right. People gonna be
right,
like, what?
Right. Skylar. She has a daughter named Skylar. So. Mm-hmm. But anyway, oh my goodness. She gave me her Instagram. She was like, follow me. So I think she DM'd me. I saw a DM. So I was like, okay, I saw the DM. I follow her. Following her for like months now, right? And then somebody said something to me like, is your friend famous? And I said, who? And I think she had commented on my page or something. And so I looked and I said, no, I don't think she's famous. Right. You know, like there was no blue check yet. Because she is verified now. I was like, who is this girl? And then I saw her last name was Epps. And I was like, Epps? And so I'm like, who is Epps? Like, you ever, like, I know this ain't who I think it is.
I know, right?
Not you just said that. Anyway.
No, because the last name is uncommon. I don't hear it a lot.
Really? Well, there's,
yeah,
well,
I didn't hear it.
Well, that's the thing. It's only one Epps that I know of. And every Epps that you know of too is Mike Epps. And so I was scrolling on her page, and I think she had a picture of her and her dad, and I was like, wait, is she connected to Mike Epps? Still didn't get it. Still didn't understand.
Didn't get it.
And then I found out that was her dad. And so I was like, oh, so you're Mike Epps' daughter? In my head. But I never wanted to make her feel any type of way. But the thing about her, she's so cool about it. Like, mm-hmm. You would never know that she's a celebrity kid. Like, she's not bratty. She's not special. She doesn't make up lies on Instagram and post them and pretend that people are pregnant. Jules.
Oh, dang. We getting right to it, I see.
Oh, girl.
See, where's my lemonade?
Yeah, we get right
to it. We definitely need some lemonade. But anyway. You have a really famous dad. How does that feel?
I mean, he's the celebrity, so I take no, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not, like you said, I was humble. I don't have a reason not to be, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. He's the celebrity. I'm very grateful. I'm just grateful to be even part of his legacy. And
come on, legacy.
Yeah, yes. I'm very grateful for that. And I mean, I love it. I'm used to it though by now.
Yes.
But thank you for all that. I appreciate that.
Oh, absolutely. Like, and you have to remember, since this is the Hive Chronicles, Mike Epps did, in fact, work with Queen B.
He did.
For the Fighting Temptations. And you were there. Tell me about that experience.
Yeah, so I was young. I don't know how, maybe 11 at the time. And he said he was doing a movie with Beyonce. And I was like, yeah, right. In my head, I'm like, no. And then when the time came, he was like, you want to come? They filmed it here in Columbus, Georgia. And when the time came, he was like, I want you to come. I want you to come to the set. I want you to meet her. And I went, and it was incredible. Like, I stayed the whole day. I watched them do a couple of scenes, and I saw her the whole day perform. Wow. But I never got to meet her until nighttime came. And then my dad took me to her trailer, and she came out. She was sweet. She gave me an autograph. She was nice. She took a picture. Like, she was so sweet. And I was stunned. Now I look back like, dang, why didn't I say this and this?
Of course.
I was stuck. Didn't say nothing. Yeah,
that is so cool.
But it was amazing, like, to see her in that space and that element. And she was young. I think that was like right before Crazy in Love.
Yes.
And that it was like right before that.
She was really young.
Just to see her take off a few months after that was insane too.
Right. And I couldn't even imagine you were on set with all those people. And you,
I know.
How old were you?
I was like 11. Yeah.
Wow.
It was amazing. Crazy to see.
I would just gag. Like,
I was already a big fan then.
Right. Mm-hmm. And that was before she became Beyoncé.
Mm-hmm.
Right. That was, you know what I'm saying? Because the if I remember, Fine Sensations came out late after her first album. Mm-hmm. That same year, but after her first album.
Yep.
So, wow. Oh, my God. Have you ever met B?
Mm-mm. Really? It's going to happen, though.
Oh, no. It's definitely going to happen. Oh, sure. No. It's definitely going to happen. Trust mm-hmm. me. It's definitely going to happen. Wow. Well, that is a story.
It is.
But you've met her.
I have.
Yeah, of course. You're the king.
I have. But, you know, it's when I met her, it was back in 07. It was 07-07-2007.
Wow. Yes, 777.
I'll never forget that day in my life. It was in Memphis, Texas. I mean, that was prophetic. That wasn't a messed up. That was prophetic. I'm going to go to Texas.
So I'm gonna stop at Memphis first. You're gonna stop in Memphis first on the way to Texas.
Because I've never been to Houston.
Me either. Me either.
No.
I'm from Houston, baby.
You are from Houston. That's why you got the Megan Thee Stallion knees.
Period.
Right. That's why.
I've never been to Houston.
No, but seriously, like I met her in Memphis, Tennessee.
Right.
At the FedEx Forum, and it was a surprise. I had no idea I was going to meet her. Wow. She had a fan club back then, $19.99 a year. Jesus, I missed them. I missed that. But she had a fan club. Her dad, like, when she was signed to Music World, and I won a meet and greet. I'll never forget what I had on. I had a Coogee red outfit.
Yes, Coogee. Oh, come on, Coogee.
You couldn't tell me I wasn't nobody.
And you was in that Coogee.
Oh my God. Was. And she even told me, she said, "You look so cute." And I said, "Thank you."
Not the Beyonce voice.
Yes, she did. So I said, "Hey, B." She said, "Hey." And so I was like so shocked when I finally met her. I couldn't believe she was so gorgeous in person. She smells like milk and honey. And if you've never been around her, you don't understand it, but you will.
You will. I promise.
You definitely will. And so I told her, I'll never forget what I told her. I told her that, you know, I want to one day work for her. And I was in college at that time, and I told her that all of my projects in college, my professors hated me because everything was Beyonce. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Everything we had to do, I was in graphic design, so I had a poster. I had to make a poster, Beyonce. I had to make CD covers, Beyonce.
Period.
I had to make DVD covers, Beyonce. Yeah, like, easy. Everything was Beyonce. And they finally told me, they was like, "Can you do something besides Beyonce?"
No.
And I said, no.
Nah.
The answer is no. But yeah, I loved every minute of that, and I told her all of those things, and she was like, "Oh, you're so cute. Thank you so much.
I love this voice."
Yeah, yes. She does that. And so she said that, and I said, "Thank you, B." And she said, "You're welcome." And then she didn't hug nobody else. Nobody else. And Julius was there, and Julius told us before we went in the room, he said, "Don't hug her. If she reached out and to shake your hand, you shake her hand. But if you do anything, we will yank you."
Whoa.
Not touch you, not yank. Take you yank. Out. He said yank. And I believed him.
Mm-hmm, you should.
I definitely believed him.
I would too.
So after that, when I went into the room, I made sure I didn't do anything, but she hugged me.
Whoa.
She hugged me.
That's a moment.
No, but it was like 20 people.
Mm.
It was like 20.
Mm.
And I was the chosen one. Mm. That's when I knew it. Ooh. I knew. That's when I knew.
Mm.
I was special.
Is.
And is.
My mom always told me I was special. Mm. But then I didn't believe it until Beyonce hugged me. I still have that Coogee shirt. And no, it is not washed.
I don't blame you. I'm not mad at that.
I need to frame it.
You should. Get a shadow box.
I should. And mm-hmm. I have a picture of the meet and greet when I won. But it's black and white because I didn't have the money back then to purchase it.
Mm-hmm.
So being Matthew, if there's a way, just DM me and we can talk about it.
Right.
Because I really need that. But I have a black and white and it says proof all on it. So you know, I can show you what it looks like.
There you go.
I just can't really show you in color.
That's all you need. Yeah, proof.
That's all you need. You know. But have any of y'all met any other like members of Destiny's Child or Jay-Z or any? So you never met anybody?
No.
Okay. It's coming.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
We're going to manifest for you.
Okay.
We're going to
put it out there. Put it out there.
I need you to. It's going to happen. It's going to happen because you are amazing.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah. I met Kelly and I met Michelle. I met Blue.
Okay. You just going to show off Blue, now. Right. Okay.
Yeah, I had to slide that in there.
I met all of them at the same time. I went to a wearable art gala 2019.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I remember that.
It was Lion King theme.
Oh.
And I met them there. Kelly was so, so sweet. Michelle, sweet. Blue was just kind of clueless. I stepped in front of her. I didn't mean to, but I did. Sweet. But they were very sweet. I met her mom. Mom is a sweetheart.
Yes.
Yeah.
I want to meet Mama Tina.
But yeah, I met them all at the same time. That was, like I said, 2019. And that's it. I haven't met Jay. I would love to.
Yeah. I think if I meet Jay, I'll probably freeze up. Mm-hmm. Because Jay is really tall, if you don't know. And so, I like tall men like that, I get kind of scared when they walk into a room.
Right.
Because
a little intimidated.
It's very intimidating. And he commands power.
He's a presence.
When he walks. Yeah, mm-hmm. He commands the presence and power when he steps into a room. And so I think I would just be like, hey, Jay.
Right, hey. I probably wouldn't say anything.
Yeah, I know I would be scared. I would. It's like, have you ever been around Julius?
Yes, but he doesn't scare me.
He definitely don't scare me. But.
Yeah, he don't give me that.
He definitely don't scare me. But he's, I'm just saying, he's, you know,
I'm screaming. He don't give me. He give me. I can get past you if I put my mind to it. You know what I mean?
I guess you're right.
And especially after I seen the shenanigans in Atlanta.
Girl, let me tell you something.
So was he? Wait,
no,
and we was there. So.
Right? Oh my God! Can we talk about that for like
just a quick second?
2 minutes. So we were, me and Bria was together at the Atlanta show when the guy jumped on the stage.
Oh yeah,
live.
It was a
mess. I got that on
mess.
Camera on accident.
No, let me tell you. So I was the first one in our little circle that realized something wasn't right. I literally saw it. I said, "Something ain't right." I just knew. I was like this because I was looking at the dancers. And they were looking crazy.
It was all bad.
And then I saw a man just jump. And I said, oh, my God. I said, and that was right at the same time where Ariana Grande's concert happened. In Manchester, mm-hmm. where the bomb happened. Mm-hmm. So my butt, my scary, scary butt was like, oh, my God, we about to die. Because I thought somebody was about to, like, do something to Beyonce. And to us.
Yeah.
I literally remember I had to sit down.
You did.
Because once it started to unfold it, now I'm filming it, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I started to get sick. I had to stop taping. That's why on YouTube, if you go to it's the Ape Shit video on YouTube. It has like a million views because at the end you see all what's going on. Mm-hmm. And so I could not believe what I saw, and I was scared for my life, everyone's life there, because we're literally right there on the stage. Mm-hmm. And then we just see him get his butt beat by the OTR guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. What was your take?
I remember you saying something that's not right,
yes,
for sure.
Yes, I kept saying it. I'm like, y'all.
And my memory is once you said that, I remember looking at the runway, which was to my left, and I saw the guy just, he was walking, and then it just took off. Mm-hmm. And he ran towards them, and then all you could see is just the dancers just kind of powling, just kicking, and mm-hmm. it was a mess. And it's just kind of like, what just happened?
Yeah.
It's one of those things where it was just like, it took me out of my element, definitely. But I was more afraid.
I was, too.
For being Jay at that moment.
Me, too.
Like, I was scared in my own mind. But I was really just terrified about being Jay. And from my understanding, he did punch Jay.
He did, yeah.
He did get a hold to Jay.
If he had touched Beyonce. I think they snatched Beyonce. I could have sworn I saw her. I feel like
she was snatched out of the way.
If he had touched my... And then what's so crazy, they didn't press charges.
No, listen. They came back the next day with so much class.
That's
the best part.
And then made a joke out of it.
That part. Beyonce turned around and did that little hi-ya.
Oh, it wasn't even that. It was the I love you, Atlanta, and it's nothing you can do about it.
Didn't she say this was my her second home?
She did.
Mm-hmm. I thought so.
She said there's nothing you can do
about
it.
Bitches is mad. They mad when she said that. Mm-hmm.
It is what it is.
But see, I saw that from, because I was in the stands.
Oh, you were here too?
Yeah.
Oh, I was there.
Yeah, that's why I said I got it on camera on accident. I didn't know what was happening until it happened. And so I was just filming them leaving like, oh my God, Bobby, you know. And I was like, what is that? Oh, he says this little person just
run.
Because mm-hmm. I always sit on that first level of riser. So I'm close enough to see her clear, but I can see the whole stage type T. And so I literally like, I'm filming, I look up and I just see him running and then I see all the dancers like jump on him. And I was like, where's Beyonce?
That was my thing. Everybody's, because at first I thought it was two people. Mm-hmm. And then I later found out it was just one crazy ass dude. Like, what was the reason? I don't know. But I don't know. Crazy things like that. I love the tours. Like, the tours are, it's like a family reunion for me.
Mm-hmm.
It's like when I go to a Beyonce concert, I know I'm going to meet people that I see online or they want to, you know, take pictures and be like, hey, oh my God, I follow you. Da, da, da. And it's so sweet when that happens. I can be anywhere. I can be at the mall and that happens.
Yep.
But it's something special about going to her tours. And I don't know about y'all, but it's time.
Baby.
Yeah, it's
been time.
It's time.
Mm-hmm. This is the longest she's gone, right?
5 years.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's been 5 long, hard, rough years. It's been 5 years.
Yeah.
It's time, Beyonce. So, being, hey, girl.
Hey, sis.
Hey.
Ready when you are.
Yeah, this is for you. Hey.
Right. It's time.
I really, really need a tour. And I think it would be best if, and I'm just going to go ahead on record and say, we need to help you. Mm. And why do we need to help you? Because we just want to help. Because we just want to.
I'm right.
Because it needs to happen. You need us. Right, guys?
I mean, y'all should
help me.
Absolutely.
You need us. Okay. You need us on payroll.
Yeah.
You need us as people to approve things by.
Yes,
not
absolutely.
That you need it, but we just miss you, sis. Like, this is a lot. I'm just pleading my case.
Yeah.
Do y'all want to chime in?
I feel like we'd be great hosts for like a pre-show situation.
Yeah,
you know? I feel like that would be really cute. A little pre-show situation.
That would be really cute.
You know, I'm going to be decked out in whatever Ivy Park is most recent at that moment.
Period.
Now, girl, we wearing custom. If we working for Beyonce,
custom.
You can't buy it.
I'm sorry, B. Let me. We're going to retract that last statement.
Yeah.
We will be dressed in the custom Ivy Park that she provided for us.
Yeah.
You know, dressed to the T, face beat.
Absolutely.
And it'll be the best host you've ever had for a pre-show situation that you haven't had yet. So what's tea?
I'm here for a little pre-show.
That was a read.
I'm here for it.
I'm here for it, too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Bria, your turn.
I mean, I was just going to say, if she needed me to, you know, hold the toothbrush, counter steps, anything she needed.
I watched the babies.
I watched the kids.
That's what I was going to say. Let's go ahead and break it down.
I was a nanny for several years.
I got to have a big job.
So, Lai already done said she gonna watch your twins that people forget. She has twins, y'all.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Jesus. People just really forget that.
Mm-hmm. Not me.
But she's willing to watch Sir and Rumi and Blue, right?
And Blue. Mm-hmm.
Right.
I have
she's
experience.
Willing to do that. Oh, you have experience too?
I was a nanny for several
Come on, resume.
Years.
Resume.
And I've been teaching children for 10 years.
Oh,
let's
resume.
That part. So you have your role. You got it. She okay, so I know you don't do it no more, but you used to do makeup.
Listen, I will bring them brushes right on.
Bring it on back. I need you to touch up.
I will come on.
I need you to do that. And then I'm gonna go on record and say I need to be in charge of the fans. See, I feel like there's no one in charge of the fans,
you
right?
Absolutely right.
The Beehive needs, I mean, I'm already, I was chosen to be called the king. I didn't, it's not my own thing. Mm-hmm. It's what people call me, king. So, I mean, I'm already that. Why not give me the title officially?
Like the experience, the fan experience ambassadors situations.
Because I want to do things for the fans, and I know she wants it too. So let's talk about it, B. Call me.
Yeah, I can also dance. She definitely need a voice.
Definitely.
For the fans.
Definitely. Well, I mean, I think our first episode was pretty good. What you think?
I agree.
It was.
I mean, it's been a long time, so I just wanted this first episode to kind of be an introduction or reintroduction. Oh, wait, hold on. Let me reintroduce myself. My name is Darone.
Right, not Darone.
Straight from the ATL. Every time I say ATL, I got to say ATL. Period. Right. But, I need y'all to make sure that you all follow us on Instagram and Twitter. At the Hive Chronicles on Instagram, as well as on Twitter. And then, Bria, give them your socials.
Yes, my social is easy. It's just Bria Epps on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok. I'm not a real TikToker, but just follow me anyways. Yeah, but yeah, I'm just Bria Epps. not a TikToker.
She's not a dancer either, but I love her.
I'm not a dancer at all.
Oh, she said at all.
I'm doing good sitting up in this chair upright.
She is. You looking cute, girl.
Yes. Let me not move.
She's the model of the group. But anyway. Okay, give me your socials.
You can find me on Instagram and TikTok at Creatively La. Real simple like.
You're so sweet. She's so sweet. You from Houston?
I'm from Houston.
I need to hear your accent. I know you got that Texas accent somewhere deep and down.
It comes out when it wants to.
Okay. We gonna try to bring it out, y'all. Okay, right. And then, of course, follow me on Instagram. I am Daron Jordan __. And I'm not on Twitter because they hate me on Twitter, but I love y'all.
They gonna hate me in a minute because I be going in on your behalf.
You do, girl, and I appreciate that.
They don't even play with me no more on Twitter.
Really appreciate
it. I didn't
that.
Even give out my Twitter for that reason.
They don't play with me on Twitter.
I've already been suspended.
Oh, and see, they suspended mine a long time ago, and I just never went back. I was like, y'all can have this. I'm on Instagram. But anyway, I thank you again, and just to let y'all know it once more, I am Darone.
I'm Bria Epps.
I'm La.
And we are
the Hive Chronicles.
We'll see you guys soon.
See y'all.
Bye.